And we begin tonight with the death of a Metro mother set on fire. Good evening, I'm Jessica Schambach.
And I'm Wendell Edwards. Sherry Mead died yesterday morning while in surgery at Baptist Hospital. Her boyfriend, Vincent Green, right there on your screen, is accused of pouring kerosene all over her body and then lighting a match.
It all happened at this home over Labor Day weekend. Eyewitness News 5's Michael Seiden spoke with Sherry's son. Michael?
Jessica, Ben Mead tells me his mother was inside sleeping. She woke up in the middle of the night. She was literally on fire. She ran out of her bedroom, busted through this front door, made it over to a neighbor's house who called 911. Now, she sustained burns to about 70% of her body, but her family says she was making improvements, but in the end, she just couldn't overcome these serious injuries.
I can't believe that I didn't know, you know.
Flipping through a family photo album, Ben Mead shows us how he and Vincent Green used to joke around like they were brothers. But tonight, there's no brotherly love.
I'm real mad, but I mean, revenge is no way to get back. Just let him deal with his own karma.
This weekend, Ben lost his best friend, his mother, Sherry Mead. The 46-year-old's death comes 3 weeks after investigators say Vincent poured kerosene on her and lit a match. Ben says it was all because his mother wanted to end the relationship.
My mom didn't want to be with him, and he couldn't handle it, apparently.
Ben says his mother was a fun-loving and hard-working woman who knew how to tell a great story. So it's been almost impossible for him to be by her side and to see her suffering with serious injuries.
Third-degree burns all over her body, everything except for her face and one of her arms.
Tonight, there's still a real sense of shock.
Never would have ever dreamt it or thought it or nothing.
But Ben is also finding some relief in his mother's death, knowing that she is no longer living in pain. And right now, Sherry's co-workers are organizing a memorial fund. As soon as that is finalized, we'll give you all the details. Reporting live in Northwest Oklahoma City, Michael Seiden, Eyewitness News 5.
Thank you, Michael. Vincent Green is being held without bond. He's scheduled to make his first court appearance on